The national celebrations to commemorate 30 years since President Museveni took power in 1986 was held in Fort Portal Town in Kabarole District, when the then rebel leader Museveni led his National Resistance Army combatants into Kampala on 25th January 1986.
Today, what has been happening in the last few days is a mere change of guard.
He came with a promise to guarantee peace and the security of person and property. This had been elusive under former President Milton Obote, President Idi Amin before him, and General Tito Okello Lutuwa's military junta, which Museveni's group disposed. A politics and governance analyst, Bernard Sabete, stresses that one of the things that the NRM government should be credited for is the prevailing peace and security countrywide. He adds that there may be the occasional spate of criminality like violent murders, as was with the case with Muslim clerics last year, but generally people can freely transact business without the fear of state-inspired terror.
NRM government with, and that is restoring sanity, especially when it comes to security matters to this country. Everybody will realize that compared to the past, Uganda is a fairly stable country security-wise. You don't have to worry when you are moving at night. You don't have to worry that any soldiers are going to stop you for no reason.
Dr. Arthur Bainimugisha, the Executive Director of Policy Think Tank, the Advocates Coalition for Development and Environment, gives the credit to the Uganda People's Defense Forces.
If you look at the in terms of the state institutions that are doing well in terms of accountability and the UPDF.
He also lauds the UPDF that evolved from a ragtag rebel outfit for its peacekeeping role in Somalia, missions in the Democratic Republic of Congo and Central African Republic.
Today is one of the enviable armies on the continent. Whether people like it or not, I think we Ugandans, but also people who are really honest, they will know and acknowledge that the UPDF has been transformed or has transformed itself into a professional army.
But Sabiti argues that 30 years of NRM and President Yoweri Museveni has seen Uganda's social indicators stagnate and even decline. He says the education and health sectors are reeling and need urgent revamp. He also feels that the inequality of huge gap between the haves and have-nots has widened significantly, presenting a social time bomb which threatens national cohesion.
Education equality. We have a very, very big problem with the quality of graduates, for example, that are coming out of our universities. Dropout rates are still very high in primary schools. We are basically raising two societies within Uganda, and this, going forward, can be very, very dangerous.
According to Sabiti, sectarianism and nepotism, which this government pledged to fight at the beginning, seem to be widely practiced in the public sphere.
We go.